Boxing superstar Errol Spence has said that he's very interested in fighting Canelo. He actually came to the Canelo fight, and he said that if he fights Terence Crawford, it has to be 60-40 or 70-30. Tim Bradley, who broadcast on ESPN, the network that Crawford fights on, had this to say on a show on ESPN. Quote, I'm quoting him, Tim Bradley. Why would you go up and face Canelo, but you won't face Crawford in the same weight as you? I think Errol Spence is at a point now, he just wants to get the money. Then he wants to leave the game. He has no intention of fighting Crawford. That's what Tim Bradley says. Now, Tim Bradley is very good friends with Crawford. It's not a secret. And he is on the network of Crawford. The reason that Errol Spence would want to fight Canelo, because Errol Spence is on the pound-for-pound list, one of the best, and Canelo is considered a pound-for-pound king. Some people have Errol as pound-for-pound king. So if you get a chance to fight the number one guy, to dare to be great, of course you would do it. Of course you're going to want to step up. And if Errol Southpaw, undefeated, who walks around 175, who spars the Charlos 15 rounds, there he is working with Coach Derek James, one of the best coaches in the history of boxing. So why would he not want to fight Canelo if he could do it? Besides the fact that a fight with Canelo sells out Dallas Cowboys Stadium, guaranteed it sells out 120,000, that here in the U.S. we've never had so many fans in one event. I'm not saying that a fight with Crawford won't sell. I'm not saying that a fight with Crawford is not epic and amazing and we'd all watch it. But you have to understand, and Tim knows this. Tim was fought Pacquiao at the highest level. He fought big fights. But Errol Spence, definitely, if he has the opportunity to fight Canelo, why would he not jump on it in two hands? That's a dream fight. That's a stadium fight. The pay-per-views will be through the roof. Errol Spence could fight me, he could fight anybody and make money. It's not just about the money. If he wanted to just make money, he wouldn't fight Danny Garcia. He would fight, I hate to say it, but a cab driver, you know, Uber driver. They don't do that. Errol Spence fights the best. He fought Mikey. He fought Sean Porter for the belt, won the belt. He fought Danny Garcia after a crash where he could have, everybody would understand if he took a very light fight just to see where he is. And he looked phenomenal against Danny. Flawless. A-plus performance. One, two, three. And also the situation with Crawford, let's be realistic. Crawford is on the contract until October, and everybody wants to see what happens next. If he renews, hey, maybe they go from there. If he doesn't renew, they also have options. So why rush it? And like I said, Spence mentioned himself that he wants a 60-40 split, and Crawford said that he wants a 60-40 split. And then Crawford said that he doesn't need Spence. And Spence's reaction to that, well, he doesn't need me, then why are we talking about it? But that's my two cents. Tim Bradley, you have to respect him. He's a former champion. He knows boxing. But without talking to Errol and without seeing where he is, you can't really assume that he just wants the Canelo fight to cash out and retire. Because that's not Errol Spence. Errol Spence is a 47-pounder, and he will move eventually to 54, and will move to 60, and maybe even 68. So there you have it. What do you guys think about what Tim Bradley said, and what's your take on it? Let me know. And do you think Spence and Crawford happens, and do you think it happens next year or maybe in 2 years? Maybe we get to see Canelo Spence before we see Canelo Crawford, and that's okay with me too. That's a mega fight. So there you have it. Stay tuned. FaceNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Secback reporting. And you can follow me on Twitter @Secback. You can follow me on Instagram @EllieSecback.